So what we have here are early frosted peas have come up, and that's taken about 5 days since we planted these. And we're gonna go over here to where we have some more of our early frosted peas, and they're gonna be going up the trellis, and they're gonna go about 36 inches. So those came up pretty good. So we'll go over here and you're gonna see where our fava beans are up now. And once again, I wanna give a shout out to David Coy with the crops, because not until last year when I saw him growing these fava beans in the middle of the winter did I say, uh-oh, I got something else that I can be growing around here. We'll go over here to our other L-shaped bed. We have our other fava beans coming up over here. And these will get to maybe about 24 inches tall. So I think that's gonna be a real nice setting to have them coming up out of the bed. And that way, if we get into a really deep frost, I can actually come out here and cover them up and it won't be a real issue. The fava beans get down to about 15 degrees, and right here in Georgia zone 8A, for the past few years, we've been getting down into the single digits. So we got down to 8 degrees last year. Worst case scenario, I'll come out and cover these up. If we have a normal Georgia winter, we should be pretty good with our fava beans, our early frosted peas, and our little marvels are going in today. We're gonna take you over here and we're gonna show you how we inoculate these seeds. So what I have right here is some of our little marvel peas. We've already inoculated these, and I just wanna show you what they look like. We'll pull one of these out of here. You see that root right there? That's what you want inoculated when you're doing your peas and your beans. Now the bacteria that's responsible for this particular inoculation right here is the leguminosarum. So we're gonna just sit those to the side for right now. We're gonna talk about nitrogen fixation. So right here we have some of our fava beans. I'm gonna give a big shout out to David Coy with the crop, because David Coy with the crop put me up on these fava beans last year, where you got a lot of people calling petri dish. I call this my petri bed. And this is where I've inoculated this bed on last year. And I continue to take soil from this bed, and I've added that soil into this bed. So this bed also has been inoculated with that leguminosarum bacteria. Now this is good for vetch, peas, and also beans. I'm also growing alfalfa, which is a legume, but this is not the same bacteria that you want for the alfalfa. The bacteria that you need for your alfalfa is called melilotti. The way that you know whether or not if your plants are fixing nitrogen, the only way to do it is to pull the plant. We're gonna try not to damage our fava beans here, because these are gonna be for our other beds in case one of the plants don't make it. We can take these and add them back into the bed. So over a million of this rhizobium bacteria to form one root nodule. But what I want to do is just show you that bacteria on there. Oh, there she go. You see those nodules right there? And they're nice and plump on there too. These are our Orient Wonders. So they're not gonna make it through this cold. We just had some mid 30 days. So that's the reason why they're looking kind of rough, and you see the difference between the colors and the way the Orient Wonders are doing and the way the fava beans are doing. The fava beans are good down to 15 degrees. It's gonna take a few months for those nodules to grow onto these particular plants. What I simply do, split this, put it into some peat moss, put a little water added to it, and that bacteria will continue to spread. So we're just gonna stick this back in here for now. And what I'm doing is taking the soil from this bed here, and I'm mixing it in with the soil right around the seeds. And that's how you move that bacteria from one area to the next. We're gonna go down here and we're gonna see if that bacteria has moved over here. So we're gonna just come over and pull this up. So this again is one of our Orient Wonders. Yes, sir. Look at that. That's the leguminosarum bacteria from the rhizobium family. And again, so we know now, not only does it work on peas, not only does it work on beans, it also works on the Orient Wonders. We're gonna put that back in the soil and just let it run its course. You'll see here where our early frosted peas have come up, and all of these have been inoculated. So now what we're gonna do is just kind of show you how we inoculate our seeds. What we have right here is some peat moss and some unsulfured blackstrap molasses. And what I have in this bottle right here is some distilled water. And I'm just gonna go ahead and saturate this a little bit. Normally I put some hot water onto the peat moss just to get it to absorb the moisture. We're just gonna mix that in. It don't necessarily have to be soaking wet. We just want it really moist. All right. So now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take some of my molasses, and it does not take a lot. And what the molasses does is basically that sugar or that food that causes those microbes to multiply. You don't need a lot, just a little bit. That's it. And we're just going to mix that molasses in to that peat moss. And this is just how simple it is to inoculate your seeds. I'm not saying that this is the way everybody else does it, but this is how I do it. So what I have here is a pack of my leguminosarum bacteria. Gonna open this up and you'll see what that looks like. But basically what this is ground up peat moss with the bacteria mixed in it. Tap that down into that peat moss. You wanna be real careful on how you move them around because you can destroy them by mixing them up too rough. As the peas start to root, that bacteria is gonna attach itself to the roots. Again, we're gonna go back to this and just let you see what it looks like after we mix this stuff in. And that's basically how it looks when I go in here. And you'll see it starts attaching itself. And what we'll do is we'll take this peat moss as well and we'll mix that into our planting holes as we go. And then that bacteria will continue to spread from bed to bed. Okay, we're gonna just drop these on the cap and then we're gonna spray our distilled water on them. We're gonna take some more of our leguminosarum bacteria, but the whole thing is you just want that to be a little damp. And we're just trying to get that bacteria to touch all of them. Mix those around. Now you can get a little paper plate or anything like that, but I'm out here in the garden. And these are finna go in now, so I just wanted to have something so you can get an idea of just how simple it is to inoculate your seeds. And again, you can do as many as you want. I'm just doing this for the demonstration. And they don't have to be all covered. You wanna use distilled water when you're doing this. This is the way that you inoculate your seeds. And that's what you're gonna have in a couple of days. This is not a very difficult task, but once you get that bacteria settled into your soil, that's 78% of the nitrogen that's in the air, now it's gonna start working for you for free, the way nature was meant to be. And we're growing out the box.